this. Bromancing already, you guys.
Let's start strong.
What's it like to be reunited after some time apart?
It feels so good.
So many emotions. Really mixed emotions.
It's good.
Joy.
Yeah. Really. It's nice seeing him here in the States again.
Yeah.
Feels good.
Are you ever going to come to my country? He mocks my country.
I mock you.
If he did come to visit, what would you do? What sights would you show
him? What would you show me?
Buckingham Palace. Take you to meet the Queens. We all know the Queen in England.
Obviously.
Everyone knows the Queen.
High tea
with the Queen. Mm-hmm. What else?
I've been to London, Max.
Have you?
Yeah.
Do you like it? It's where you learn your immaculate English accent.
I love it.
Hello, I'm Max Irons.
So offensive.
Well, I'm here to let you guys know you already have a huge fan base. And I sent out one singular tweet to our followers, and the response was slightly overwhelming. You got lots of marriage proposals, actually, in case you're available. At Ian O'Shea, oddly, that's a Twitter handle, by the way, wants to know, who is the funniest person in the movie? Also, by the way, this person proposed marriage.
Oh, did they?
Yes.
To who? To which one of us?
Just in general.
Oh, just marriage.
You guys.
Do they have a picture?
No. I'll have to send it to you.
Okay.
I'll send it to you guys.
We'll do that afterwards.
Yeah, we'll discuss.
Is that creepy? I didn't.
No.
Complimentary.
Okay. Can I use it?
What was the question?
The funniest person.
Who's the funniest person? No one had a sense of humor in this movie. It was really quite
very
tragic.
Serious.
Very, very serious. Yeah. Very actorly. Very
actorly.
London stage.
Yes, like London. We don't joke in England.
No, not at all. Next question comes from at Rosie Haperi, who had tons of questions, by the way. What cast member would actually survive living in caves if the earth was overtaken by souls?
William Hurt. The man we filmed out in the spine of mountains out in New Mexico. And it was his last day of filming, and we were at least a mile or two out. And he was so overwhelmed with the wrap of the film that he walked back to base camp 2 miles in the desert alone.
He's very in touch with nature.
Yes.
He's the kind of guy that you'd expect him coming over the horizon being followed by tigers,
the animals,
lions,
the kingdom,
birds,
yeah.
All just sitting on his
So shoulder. While I don't doubt your survival skills,
yeah.
Because you drove a car with no steering very well.
That was good, wasn't it?
That was very good. Yeah. But you did not walk back in the desert.
I was asked in an interview yesterday what would be my three comforts in my cave, and I said a bathtub, a double bed, and scented candles.
So
and it just
like
came off very
seasons.
Quickly, and then I thought, that's not conducive to survival, really.
So as I mentioned, you guys got lots of marriage proposals from all of our followers, and we have the lovely British representative, an American representative here. What do you guys think each of you, or would you say in general, that American guys have as sort of a, you know, a thing that girls would like, and a British guy would have that?
Well, the accent's like. Really unfair, especially filming in America.
Thank you. This is the first nice thing he's ever said about English people.
Lovely.
So sweet.
No, I mean it's incredible. You see him go out. I mean we went to a mall to buy sunglasses one day, and the girls in the sunglass shop, as soon as they heard his accent, they're just like, oh my God, what can I get you? Those look great on you.
Yeah. I had no idea.
Yeah. That was remarkable. Really remarkable.
Tell me next time.
I will. Well, I thought you knew.
English
give me a compliment.
English guys have very bad teeth, so gorgeous teeth.
Gorgeous teeth. Let's see that smile. Oh, wonderful. The bromance continues.
If only we could be sitting closer.
Last question. Why should people go see The Host when it hits theaters in March?
Because I think it has something for everyone. You know, it's got the philosophical aspect, it's got the action, it's got the romance, it's got the science fiction. We've got fantastic actors. Fantastic director, and
at the end of the day, I think it's a really fun flick. I mean, like you said, something that I think parents can bring their kids, young people can bring dates to. It isn't really kind of single one sort of demographic out.
And I think it'll leave something with you. It'll make you think after you leave the movies.
Things explode, people kiss.
What more could you want, guys?
Hollywood.
It is no longer your